Who better to talk about the quarterback replacement program? Trevor is gone. DJ steps in. What do you expect to see?
Yeah, Wendy, I expect a great play. Exactly what he showed last year in those two games, the first one being against Boston College. And again, that wasn't an easy game for DJ to come in and play. Look, Boston College punched them in the gut in that first half, but with his prowess and his understanding, his confidence, he was able to will them back and get that victory. And then that second game, Notre Dame, he looked clean. It wasn't like they lost the game because of what DJ did. He did an excellent job of taking care of the football. And guys, I got a chance to meet him here today in person. He's a big guy, pretty much looking at me eye to eye. So he's about 6'5", maybe 6'5 and a half, big hands. And so I'm excited to see what Big Cinco can bring to this Clemson football team.
Well, I think he's got Tiger fans fingers crossed anyway. Travis Etienne moves on, though, as well. So it's not just the quarterback. Who steps in and replaces Etienne?
Yeah, Wendy, I'm tired of everyone talking about Trevor Lawrence as if, like, he was the only superstar they had on that fantastic team. You know what I mean? They had Travis Etienne, who was an excellent running back for, like, 3 or 4 years for Clemson. Very productive. And what I really liked about Travis Etienne from 2019 to 2020, when his productivity slowed down as a running back as far as carrying the ball, he actually reinvented himself as a receiver, a viable receiver for Trevor Lawrence coming out of the backfield. So not only are they going to miss Trevor Lawrence, but the leadership and the experience and knowledge and the dual threat ability as a guy who could run with the ball or catch the ball out of the backfield that Travis Etienne brought to the offense, that's going to be some big shoes that they're going to have to fill. I think it's going to be multiple guys, Wendy. I don't think there's one guy who could fulfill the role that Travis Etienne had last year or the last 3 years for Clemson. I believe it's going to be multiple guys to try to fill that position.
Yeah, I mean, that's kind of the way it works when you have a player the caliber of Etienne. I thought you might say that about the quarterback, by the way, Dez. I had a feeling. EJ, I'll go back to you because when you talk about that teamwork, that committee approach, they do get Justin Ross back. What will that look like?
Yeah, well, look, getting Justin Ross back is huge. One, because this guy's going to be completely healthy. Obviously, he missed last season recovering with a back injury, but you're talking about a guy that's been walking around looking like Julio Jones from what I've been told. And this guy can be a special player, and he's already shown light of being, I think, a top 10 pick when he comes out into the NFL draft. Again, that's going to give DJ even more confidence to throw those 50-50 balls. And guys, don't forget, it's not just going to be Justin Ross. It's going to be EJ Williams, Frank Ladson Jr., Joseph Ngata. So look, you talk about the size that Clemson's bringing back a receiver. That's what's going to be special when these guys line up, when 11 personnel is going to be scary.
Yeah, EJ, you know that the one thing you need for a quarterback who's about to start the season, you know, he played some games, he started some games, but to start the season, you want some veteran guys around him. And bringing a guy like Justin Ross, who's an extraordinary wide receiver, he can make all the catches, he can get vertical, he can run short routes, he can run the whole route tree, and he has a lot of confidence. He's the guy who's going to be able to give DJ the confidence out there on the field if it starts to wane a little bit, if he starts to have any sort of doubt. You look at Justin Ross, and he's going to be the man that's going to pick DJ up and pick up the offense. So to bring in a guy, that bring him back, that's that talented coming off of injury, is a huge boost for Clemson's offense.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.